A warm welcome back to what is the last concert in our little online festival. We've put together footage from concerts given by the Elias Quartet, in which they played Schumann's A minor quartet, and a concert given by us, the Gould Piano Trio, in the Wigmore Hall last year, recorded on the BBC, in which we are playing Brahms's great B major trio and some little pieces by Theodor Kirchner, Bunte Blätter, or Colourful Leaves. In the interval, there's a chance to be a sort of fly on the wall and take part, or at least watch, a little Zoom chat that the Gould Trio had with the Elias Quartet, just catching up on how life has been in lockdown and the sort of things that we've been up to more recently. Thank you very, very much for being our audience for this event. We hope very much, of course, that we'll be able to present the festival back in the flesh next year, fingers crossed, and that you'll be able to join us for that. In the meantime, if you'd like to donate or support the work that we're doing, you'll find details of how to do that on the Corbridge Shane Music website, or indeed on this YouTube channel website.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to our interval Zoom chat. We are, as you know, the Gould Piano Trio on the top row, assuming that your top row is the same as ours. And underneath us, we have the marvellous Elias String Quartet, who, of course, would have been our celebrated guests at the festival had it been going according to plan. But we've got them, and they are all in different parts of the world, and they're going to tell you a little bit where they are each time we talk to them. So this is a very informal discussion, and I'm just going to start the ball rolling by asking Sarah, maybe could you just give us a bit of a clue as to what's been happening over the last few months for you and how you're kind of coping with the news current situation. I know that you've, of course, had a very exciting arrival, so that's made life very different for you anyway, but let's see what's been going on.
Well, hi everyone. I have a son, a 4-month-old son, and that's actually, it's made this situation a little bit like I feel very different from everyone else, because I've basically been doing what I would have been doing anyway, which is not doing anything except caring for my son. But with all this, you know, terrible stuff going on around, but I feel like I've really been in a bubble. I'm in the south of France at my parents', in the nature, in the countryside, so even during lockdown, you know, I didn't feel so confined, and it's just been a really beautiful time for me, really. And it's only in the last few weeks that I'm starting to like come back to reality a little bit and starting to think what that reality is going to be, and that's quite scary, I find. Probably also even more because I haven't really dealt with it at all. I've really been in my bubble and my honeymoon with my son, and so yeah, that's me. I haven't never spent so long without playing the violin, and I've tried playing in the last few weeks, and let me tell you, you don't want to hear it.
So actually, in a way, the lockdown came at exactly the right time for you. I mean, because of course you wouldn't have been very active anyway with the quartet. Did you have a planned sabbatical anyway for the whole quartet? Maybe Donald, you could answer that. Where are you, by the way, Donald?
So I'm in Glasgow in Scotland, and but it has been very sunny in Scotland, I have to say, unusually sunny, which has helped with the lockdown. And the quartet's plans, we were doing some concerts with some guest violinists, actually. So we had just finished a tour of the States right before lockdown. And Sarah was going to be coming back to us, I think the last week of May or right the beginning of June, to be rehearsing again and doing concerts, including your festival, which we're very sad not to be at.
Right. So have you been managing to sort of occupy yourself gainfully, or are you depressed by it all?
I'm just trying to take every day as it comes, really, and definitely it kind of goes in phases, ups and downs, but just trying to get out as much as possible, get some exercise. Now that we can kind of see friends, I'm finding it much easier, you know, go for a nice walk and things like that. But it's been okay, but I'm glad that it looks like we're getting through the worst of it.
Can I just chip in, Donald? Have you been busy with the work from the RNCM?
Yeah, so that's been quite a crazy experience, working there and trying to get an institution online in very short notice. Mm-hmm. So it was very intense, actually, trying to get, especially for the students finishing this year, trying to get them assessed and hearing them. And I think, you know, I work in chamber music there, so that's the most difficult job, because students can, you know, can't be in a room together. So it's been a real puzzle, and we've made our way through it. But I, yeah, I just I can't wait. I think all the students can't wait just to be able to play music together in the same room again, you know.
Have you been much online?
Yeah, been teaching. Yeah, done some teaching online, which is actually has been surprisingly rewarding. Like it's a different way of working, but it's amazing to be able to see a student from your own living room, and it can be really regular, and there's no kind of not such time limits, time constraints.
As long as the internet connection is good enough to make it work. That's been my experience, that if it's, you know, it can be a disaster if it's not, you know, it's awful. So.
Yeah.
How about you, Marie? What's been going on for you?
So I'm in London in my flat, and I have been since lockdown. It's been, well, like Don says, it's been up and down. The first sort of month of it, I actually really enjoyed it because I was really exhausted, and just being in my own bed every night was a real change. And I did spend a month without playing at all, which is also quite revolutionary. But of course, that sort of got old quite quickly. And so I've just been also walking a lot, discovering a lot of the parks that I'd never seen around my place. Cooking a lot more than I have. I think we've all pretty much done the same things. and it's just about going through the bad days and trying to... I found it hard to... keep myself really up to date and informed with what's going on, but not to an extent that I'm obsessed with it. So that's a hard balance to find. And yeah, basically can't wait to start again playing with people. I'm also finding playing on my own really boring now. And realizing that I'm exactly in the right job because I love playing with people, and yeah, that's what I'm missing most of all is interaction, whether it is musical or social.
Difficult. It's been very difficult. There's a lot of anxiety around as well, I find.
Yeah.
You know, it goes up and down, doesn't it? Sometimes you feel great, sometimes you feel fine. Oh, it's so wonderful not to be stressed. Not to get nervous, that aspect of things marvelous. But then I've had this sort of anxiety that actually I'm never going to be able to play a concert again. I just won't be able to do it, you know. I think it's completely irrational, but somehow it's a strange fear that's come up. Yeah.
I'm just wondering.
Sorry. No, I agree, and even, you know, watching either old concerts or videos or, you know, other people's concerts, it seems like an unreachable level that is just never going to happen again. And
your own concerts?
Sorry?
You mean recordings of your own concerts?
Well, any, actually.
How did we ever do
that? Yeah. It's just when you're not in it, it just seems sort of unattainable.
Yeah.
I had a weird experience that the radio was on, and it was some amazing symphony, and the applause afterwards was, it was the end of the Berlioz Symphony Fantastique, and the applause from the Albert Hall was just incredible. It just really kind of affected me, because I thought, crikey, you know, we're missing that, and that's sort of something you can't recreate anywhere. And it made me realise how actually we're doing this for, you know, it is a buzz, actually. And so we're missing a whole sort of side of adrenaline kick that, you know, concerts are normal for us, but actually that side of things has just been taken away. And I hadn't quite realised that. I'm just wondering if we should get on to the next topic, and we could start with Simone. What do you think, Richard?
I mean, the time is nearly nigh for the next half of the concert, actually. So
yeah. I just...
Sorry. Go ahead.
Can I just ask if you're doing anything towards future repertoire projects yet? Are you able to do that while you're all on your own? Are you learning new notes? And what are your repertoire plans?
Should we direct that to Simone, then you can tell us where you are?
Well, this year, actually, of course, being Beethoven's year, we had a lot of cycles planned, and you know, they're just not going ahead in the format that they would have been. But we're of course thinking and looking in all kinds of ways we could somehow do something in streaming or something. And actually, for personally, there's still a few Beethoven quartets I haven't played, which is quite exciting in itself. So I've kind of been playing some of those parts, quartet parts, by myself.
Yes, but, why not?
But that's something, you know, to look forward to in a way, and hopefully we will still be able to do some of those in the future.
Yes, I remember when Robin Ireland joined the Lindsay Quartet, he had to learn a lot of Beethoven quartets quite quickly.
And Bartok, I think, as well. Beethoven and Bartok were the ones that...
Yeah,
that's my right. Goodness. Really cycles immediately, crazy.
Yeah, totally. All right, well, look, it's great to see you all. It's wonderful for us to be able to get together, if only Zoom-wise. we wish you enormous amounts of happiness and luck for the future, and hope that we can all get back together very soon and start doing what we're supposed to do, which is playing chamber music. So anyway, here we go for the second half of our presentation, our concert. Lovely to see you all. Enjoy yourselves. Okay.
Thanks, Richard.
Bye.
Thank you. Thank you.